Heat 3 great for Micromax. Quaker on pole from Oliver Sibbald. Then Robertson Boyd, Lauder and Simpson from Rory Armstrong and Charlotte Stanley. Aston Brown and Ollie Hipkins from Sebastian Corking. The two big names from the last heat at the back of the grid for this one. Apart from snow, we've literally had all four seasons of weather here this weekend at Rowra. It's sunny, the slicks are out, and it's time to go racing and time to fly the drone once more. Here we go. 7 more minutes on the clock. And the drivers will battle once more. No problems at all from the front for Zane Quaker. Straight out in front and into the lead. Now, which way will he disappear? Straight on, if he's got any say in it. But 37 is there in second. James Roberts and Oliver Sibbald, the man in third place, who is literally knowing this circuit inch by inch. He's going to be one to watch.
Absolutely. Zane Quaker won the first heat, of course, and then six in that second heat. That will have hurt his championship points, no doubt about it. He won't like that, but... He knows he's starting on pole with Sebastian Corking, for example, starting at the back. His main opposition in the championship started well behind him. He'll be hoping for maximum points here. Two wins and a six. He'll probably take that going into the final. Should give him pole.
Two different winners from two races as Armstrong pops up the inside and moves up into fourth position. So that's a good run there from Armstrong as he gets the move on the inside of the 88 of Braden Boyd. We're on board this time with Charlotte Stanley. Oh, a nice move there on the inside of Caden Simpson. And it's not the only one making the move. I think that's Corking getting through as well. So Corking makes up the place, and that puts him up another position as well. So great 360-degree camera from Charlotte Stanley in this third heat. And we ride on board with her for the duration. Now, Quaker out in front. Roberts second, Sibbald third. Sibbald actually pushing the limits a little bit already. Here's Corking trying to make the bid on Charlotte Stanley. Look at the graining on the tyres already as the slick tyres are obviously getting a lot of punishment in the dry conditions around this circuit. Here comes Corking making the bid up the inside. That'll do. Thank you very much. Stanley tries on the switch to recover the place. Corking very much has it made.
Fantastic driving by Sebastian Corking. Started P11 in this one, of course, back of the grid. Started pole last time. And the way random grids work, if you start on pole, you'll get one on pole, you'll get one at the back of the field and one in the middle. And that's what he's had in the three heats so far. 22 there, Charlotte Stanley. Zane Quaker sets the fastest lap again.
I personally love the system of random grids. It's what makes this a proper racing system. You learn everything.
Yeah, old school karting. When I thought about doing this championship, I thought, I'm not doing the qualifying rubbish nonsense. I can't stand qualifying.
Well, I've sat there in many types of karting paddock. You sit there in an eight-minute session and you wait
boring.
4 minutes for them all to get out.
It's boring.
And then they
Absolutely go,
I've been held up. I got blocked by my lap. I didn't get a toe. I'll just send them out on random grids. That's the way to do it.
I mean, this year, of course, we've been affected badly by the pandemic. People weren't able to test the carts and the engines. So we've ended up what we've ended up with. We had 11 at the first round, or 10 at the first round, 17 at the second round. Smaller numbers today. Next time at Hooton Park, I'm expecting us to have maybe 15 or 16. Got some local drivers there that I think are going to join.
I think we saw Hipkins having a bit of an issue there with Corking as, oh, goodness me, that was close for Boyd and Lauder. Did Hipkins get through? Yes, he did get through on Corking because they were side by side and those two are trying to go through the field together. Quaker, another new fastest lap, 53.26, 3.9 seconds clear of Roberts. This early, that's amazing. And now side by side again, Boyd and Lauder still swapping paint if they're not careful. Into the braking zone, a big lunge from Boyd, drifts wide. Lauder gets him on the switch, lovely.
Great race. There's always someone to race against, and that's what's great about this championship.
Armstrong trying to get through on Sibbald. Not quite able to get there to third position, but still pushing and hustling his way through the course. Armstrong tries again. Sibbald knows where to get the cart lined up for the braking point into St. John's. As they go through Sunny, he's got the opportunity.
Out through Paddock Bend one more time. I was saying earlier about Hooton Park, we should have 15 or 16, I think, for the next round. Next year, looking forward, hoping for sort of something over 20, 25 maybe, judging on the inquiries that we've had. Next year, we will not be clashing with any of the other major championships. We'll wait for their dates to come out, and then we'll pick dates where there's no clashes so the guys can do this and they can do anything else they want to.
Well, don't take it personally, but I'm not telling my son this championship exists. I don't want him to get any hint of the idea because otherwise that's going to get pricey for me. Stanley on the inside, makes the bid on Boyd, gets through. Nice recovery drive from Charlotte Stanley. just look at the tyres. You can see just how much muck and rubbish gets put onto the main surface of the tyre just by pushing. You've got, I think there was a little fleck of wood or something that had come up from a wood chipping or something that was planted on the tyre.
The tyres get pretty hot, you have to say. So anything like, you know, if there's a small sliver of wood or something on the track, it will pick it up.
Well, the great Formula One legend Juan Manuel Fangio, he used to throw coins out on test sessions and he would slide the car in to pick them up onto the tyres just to improve his skills. Very similar to karts, of course, those old 1950s F1 cars, so it would have been a great skill. They always used to say, you know, could the modern Formula One drivers handle the old eras? I tell you what, the modern kart racers definitely could have hacked it with the 1950s F1 drivers. Very similar driving styles. So I think they would have easily hacked it. Oh, nice move on the inside coming. That's a big launch from Armstrong. Can he shut it down on the exit? Yes, he can. Nice move there on Roberts.
Fantastic driving by the man from Northern Ireland. The commitment this young man gives to karting in the UK, this championship and the other championships that he takes part in as well, is quite remarkable. They're coming from Northern Ireland every single weekend, it seems, to race or test somewhere. Quite remarkable, and it's a great tribute to him and his family.
Well, the last time anyone from Northern Ireland won a Formula One Grand Prix was the Malaysian Grand Prix in 1999. That was Eddie Irvine. It's about time we had another. Here we go. A nice little battle in there. That was Hipkins getting in there with Lauder, I think, trying to get through into sixth position, and I think he made it.
He certainly did. That's Hipkins' upper place. He won't be happy, I think, that the sun's come out, Jake.
No, indeed.
He will definitely be hoping it rains for the rest of the season, because he could be a championship contender if it does.
Well, just
clearly
look
in the wet and corking as well.
Look at the dry pace that Quaker has got. 7.2 seconds clear of Armstrong, Roberts and Civil. That's insanity. Absolutely incredible pace. Mark Baines must be grinning all the way to the bank. A fabulous, fabulous run from Zane Quaker as he continues to lead, and he's still banging in fast laps. A 52.7 now from Zane Quaker. Armstrong trying to stretch away from Roberts and Sibbald and hang on to second place as those two continue to battle. Now here is Lauder trying to shake off Stanley, and behind you've got Boyd and Brown. Now in the dry you can see just how much closer they are together, because in raw pace the dry shows just how close these four drivers are in terms of ability. The rain is a bit of an unknown factor, especially for those novices who are still getting to know the art of the sport and trying to figure out just how much different the grip levels are. Here's Sibbald. Even he can't quite find the move on Roberts. And you would think that young Sibbald, who knows this place incredibly well, would be able to find it. But Roberts just leaving his braking on the Haas chassis as late as humanly possible. Good to see him keep hold of that third place under very tough circumstances.
Zane Quaker, the leader, going through the finish line. He'll have got the last lap board when he did. Big lead he's got.
It's gargantuan,
incredible,
isn't it?
Lead. Yeah.
Absolutely phenomenal how much of a gap he's been able to build.
Someone got Paul Clusen's number.
Oh dear, don't start. 33, Lauder and Stanley now battling for position. Charlotte Stanley trying to get the move into the first corner on Logan Lauder. And this could have a big ramification, because you've got Boyd and Brown queuing up behind as well. They want to pick up a point of extra or two. Stanley on the inside, and she squeezes through, and Lauder's gone wide. So Boyd and Brown pick up the places. I think Lauder has actually parked it.
I think he's thrown a chain, Jake.
Oh, no.
Must have thrown a chain.
Just catching the curb, and that's all it takes sometimes. What an unfortunate end of the race for Logan Lauder. But here is Zane Quaker, marches to the victory. Checkered flag. Thank you very much indeed. These two still battling for third place. Armstrong's going to have second. Roberts trying to keep the door firmly shut. Sibbald picks it up on the inside. Side by side to the line. Sibbald snatches it from the jaws of defeat. Excellent work. Just gets there by a couple of millimetres. A perfect run out of the final turn. And Sibbald snatches third place. A great final lap battle there from those three two. Stanley, Boyd and Brown. Zane Quaker, 8.8 clear of Rory Armstrong. Different league. Oliver Sibbald, a whisker in front of James Roberts. Sebastian Corking ahead of Ollie Hipkins. Then Charlotte Stanley, Braden Boyd, Aston Brown and Caden Simpson, your top 10. The final is next, and it's going to be tough to beat Quaker.